Three astronauts on China's Tiangong space station just lost their ride home. Their return capsule has a cracked window from space junk. And for a while, they had no dedicated way to get back to Earth. So how did this happen? And why is this the second time in 2 years we've basically stranded a crew in orbit? Here's the situation. China's Shenzhou 20 spacecraft carried three astronauts to Tiangong for a long mission. When it was time to come home, engineers spotted tiny cracks in one of the return capsule's windows, most likely from a small piece of space debris hitting the glass. Even a hairline crack is a huge problem. During re-entry, the outside of that window is slammed by super-hot plasma and high air pressure. If the outer glass fails, you risk losing pressure inside the capsule. In other words, it's a no-go for a crewed landing. So the Shenzhou 20 crew had to wait in orbit an extra 9 days until the next ship, Shenzhou 21, arrived with their replacements. When it docked, Tiangong briefly had six astronauts on board. And then the outgoing crew did something unusual. They climbed into the fresh Shenzhou 21 capsule and used it to come home, leaving the new three-person crew on the station without their own emergency lifeboat. China's fix is now in motion. They're preparing an uncrewed Shenzhou 22 on a Long March 2F rocket set to launch from the Jiuquan Satellite Launch Center and dock with Tiangong as a replacement escape ship. Once it's there, the Shenzhou 21 crew can finish their six-month mission and return safely around April 2026. But the fact that we ended up with a crew in orbit and no dedicated way home exposes a bigger problem. This isn't just a China issue. In 2024, NASA astronauts Butch Wilmore and Suni Williams flew Boeing Starliner to the International Space Station for what was supposed to be a short test flight. Starliner made it to orbit, but along the way, it developed helium leaks and thruster problems. NASA decided the safest move was to bring the capsule back to Earth empty so they could study it, while the astronauts stayed on the ISS. Wilmore and Williams were eventually reassigned to a long-duration ISS mission and didn't come home until March 2025, riding back on a SpaceX Crew Dragon instead of the vehicle they launched on. In both cases, Starliner at the ISS and Shenzhou 20 at Tiangong, the crews were lucky. They had a full space station, other docked spacecraft, and time to improvise a solution. But what if they hadn't? On Earth, we have search and rescue teams for almost everything. Ships at sea, hikers in the mountains, even remote plane crashes. In orbit, there is no true space coast guard. Right now, almost all space rescue is self-rescue. Your spacecraft has to keep the crew alive long enough for help to be readied. A backup ship has to be fueled, checked out, and launched on very short notice. And the timing has to line up with the station's orbit, which can delay things even if the rocket is ready. In theory, having a dedicated rescue system is powerful. Even if your main spacecraft isn't perfect, giving the crew a second independent way home can dramatically increase their overall chances of survival. But building, maintaining, and regularly testing a standby rescue vehicle is extremely expensive, and those budgets are always tempting targets when a program runs over schedule. So again and again, we quietly accept more risk instead of paying for a true rescue capability. The Shenzhou 20 crack and the Starliner saga both ended safely, but they were also warnings. As more countries and private companies send people into orbit, tourists included, getting stuck at a space station is becoming less hypothetical and more routine. At some point, we'll have to decide. Do we treat spaceflight like airline travel or like test pilot territory, where rescue is basically optional? If you want more clear, no-hype breakdowns of stories like this, hit subscribe and stick around for the next QuickByte.